the studio started really in 1999 when we were in college, myself, Tom and Nora, and it sort of initially started just myself and Tom taking on a job because we needed to earn money. When we graduated, we all came down to Kilkenny and then started the Cartoon Saloon.
We had one computer, I think, initially, and a bunch of paper to draw with. At the heart of Cartoon Saloon, there's just a bunch of people who like drawing together and telling stories together, and that doesn't change. Everybody who's drawn to the company also just wants to make cool stuff together.
I came myself from illustration, and both Tom and Nora also were into hand-drawn and kind of 2D, whether it's 2D digital or 2D on paper. So we still want to have that feeling that we're making an illustration. So there's that kind of storybook kind of feel through most of our stuff. And I think that's helped us, because when we started at the time, there wasn't many people making 2D animated films. The way for us to sort of stand out a little bit was to like lean into the 2D look. So lean into that kind of like very composed, illustrative look. And I think it's helped us a lot, because I think it's helped distinguish us.
I've been working now in Cartoon Saloon for quite a few years, and for me it's always been a very collaborative and open environment. And one of the lovely things about working here is that you get to, you know, work with the really amazing artists, but also just a great team overall. So that includes production, people in administration, everybody's working together, I would say, for the same goals in mind.
You eat just the peel and not the fleshy part?
Of course not.
Then this is gonna work out just fine.
Cartoon Saloon has a really great relationship with the city of Kilkenny, where we're based. It's just the perfect creative atmosphere, and the people of Kilkenny have always been so welcoming and open-hearted to all of our crew.
It's very friendly. You cross the road, you meet somebody you never met before, and you go, hi, and you go, hi, guess. It's very refreshing coming from cities where the environment is hostile. Here it's really, really friendly and relaxed.
Kilkenny's got a great personality in itself. It feels a bit like a character too. It has this medieval charm, but it also has the old Irish weather as well. I think people often find that they can kind of socialise a lot here, because we're in a small enough town that we're all living essentially locally. So that's always been a really nice, I think, for a lot of people who come here from abroad or from other places in Ireland. And it was the same for myself. I'm from Dublin, and moving down to Kilkenny was kind of like becoming automatically part of a community that already existed here, which is wonderful.
Most animation studios are in the big cities like London, Dublin, Los Angeles, New York. You know, there's something about going away from that larger scene and being on your own, I think, helps. You become more of a tight-knit group. It's good for focus, because I'm very easily distracted. So if I think I lived in a bigger city, I'd just be distracted by too many things.
There's an arrow. Nope, nope. There's an arrow. No. Sorry.
Hey, alarm. You know what? I'll be the arrow finder, okay?
Sure.
We've always tried to keep the company in the heart of Kilkenny. You can go out and you can take a walk in the park. You can put your hand on a tree that's like 200 years old. Nature is part of everything that we do. To draw or to paint or to animate means you have to slow down. To animate 4 seconds of animation, it takes an animator an entire week to do that. So you have to slow right down to part of a sentence or to the breath of a character. Nature slows you right down and reminds you that no matter what's going on in your life, you're made of something that's part of a cycle and a larger cycle. You'll never forget that when you're in Kilkenny.
Do not touch the stuff in my backpack. Got it?
Really?
I mean it.
Okay.
You have to make a lot of story choices even before you start production, because we don't want to like animate 10 minutes of a scene and then have to cut it out because it's way too expensive. We have to write the script, then spend a lot of time with storyboarders, put that together as an animatic, and then watch the film as a black and white kind of comic strip to time it and see, okay, does this work as a movie now?
Morning, Della.
Morning.
Morning, Omer.
Morning, Magda.
What have you got for us today?
Tangerines.
And one of the biggest challenges we had early on was actually the variety of character designs on the film. So we have everything from Elmer, Mom, Mrs. McLaren, these human characters, all the way to, you know, silverbacks, little pikas, rhinos, and everything in between. So trying to kind of encapsulate a style that would work for both humans and all of these animals was one of the challenges that we had to deal with early on.
this film from the first draft of the screenplay all the way through to the final mix of the sound, that takes about 5 years. So you know that the story that you want to tell and spend that 5 years telling can't be something flippant, can't be something that you're not really interested in or something that's not going to take your attention for that length of time. You need to be able to put your hand on the heart of the story and let that sustain you.